This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:3 and 4, tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ, amen, died for our sins, according to Scripture. He was buried. He rose again the third day, according to the Scripture. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, come with sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nothing, even in your heart and your mouth. There's a word of faith which I preach. You will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God had raised him from the dead. You shall be saved. With heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Thank God, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast on live stream at Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, at other devices. Kathie Davidson, co-host, seated to my left. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Doing well.
Very good. I have had an interesting morning, to say the least. Last week before, I'm not sure when it was, but the Lord told me that to press in, push in, he said. He said, I am here to help you gain the victory.
Right.
Well, I never forget that when the Lord talks. Well, normally I don't. And so I've kept that in mind. Well, this morning was a tough walk. You know that.
Yes.
Tough. I came here, got on the couch, and I was so without strength. And I just said, Lord, you said you were here to help me. So I need your help. And I tell you, it wasn't a few minutes I could feel things easing up.
Amen.
Oh, yes. It was, I said, you must be helping me.
Amen.
You know, he said, Paul said, at his first answer, no man stood with him but the Lord.
But the Lord, right.
Right?
Right.
That's been the same here. But anyway, within 10, 15 minutes, and I'm ready for more.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah.
Because that's not how you left the home.
You are exactly right. Would you like to read 1 Corinthians 14,
sure will.
26?
1 Corinthians 14, 26. How is it then, brethren? When you come together, every one of you has a psalm, has a doctrine, has a tongue, has a revelation, has an interpretation. Let all things be done unto edifying. If any man speak in an unknown tongue, let it be by two, or at the most by three, and that by course, and let one interpret. But if there be no interpreter, let him keep silence in the church, and let him speak to himself and to God. Let the prophet speak two or three, and let the other judge. If anything be revealed to another that sitteth by, let the first hold his peace, that you may all prophesy one by one, that all may learn and all may be comforted. And the spirits of the prophets are subject to the prophets, for God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints.
Read 1 Corinthians 15.
Any particular place you want me to start?
Grace.
Okay.
What we posted.
That's right. It says, verse 10, but the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me.
You want to say something about that?
Well, you and I have been talking about that grace.
I know.
That you put an interesting post up last night.
Yes.
And I had to think about it for a while.
Right.
And you said that God gave you faith for money, a lot of money.
That's right.
And, you know, it says, it's interesting. God says, faithful in little, faithful in much.
Right.
Well, you were faithful in little. You have been faithful in a lot of money.
Right.
I mean, millions.
Right.
And have given, what, $25 to $30 million away.
$25 to $30, and I've got nothing, I own nothing, and my ministry is probably worth about $1.5 million.
But, and what probably needs to be said is you did not have that $25-30 million when you started giving it away. It was not there. It got you. You had faith for the money to come, and then you gave it away. And to give it away.
And give it away.
That's right. In other words, you weren't born rich with a silver spoon in your mouth that had all this money to give away. That was not the way it was.
That's true.
You believed God. But then you said in that post, you said, it was not the faith. It was my faith.
Oh,
word it right, because I want to make sure I write it.
I said, my faith brought the grace.
There.
And the grace is what gave it away.
That's brought the money.
The money.
In the post, right. The grace brought the money.
The grace has done everything.
That's right. Paul could go as far as the grace that was given him would let him go. And he could go no further. I mean, that grace was there. Paul said, I labored more abundantly, more than they all. But it was not me. It was the grace that was with me.
Sure. You know, I gave away millions. I know. At one time, I knew. But I don't even know now. But knowing that I didn't have one thing myself.
Amen.
Nothing. And then, I had a house in Fairview. And I bought that as a veterinarian. And then, God moved. And causes all this money to start coming to me. And it was wonderful. But I knew to give it away. And I gave it to everybody. There's not too many preachers I haven't given money to.
But you know, but you gave it where God told you. You didn't just start handing it out.
Led by the Spirit to give it.
That's exactly it.
Sure. Listen, I gave a lot of money to preachers that ate my guts.
Amen.
They do. They resist everything I do. I gave money to a preacher that I heard in the Spirit once say, oh, that guy's a fool.
Bother they had me. No problem taking your money.
No. None of them did. I never had anybody send it back.
I think you had one.
Who?
The group from Israel.
What?
A group from Israel.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? What's funny, I still get their email.
I know.
They explain everything.
They still tell you what they need.
Amen. So, the grace. But it was so neat, Kathie, to have all of a sudden things just begin to ease up.
Thank God.
And ease up. And I said, this must be Jesus doing this. He wouldn't say a word. He likes to play with me. Try my faith. Amen. All right. I want to say this about these songs. The grace of God is upon them. Guided by his faith. My faith. My prayer. If you need help, you need to learn now. These tapes can bring you through anything that is in front of you that's troubling you, if you can believe.
Amen.
Look, this is my ministry, Terry's ministry, bringing forth fruit, what God said. You need to listen to it when you're in trouble. You need to listen to it when you're not in trouble. Keep you out of trouble.
That's good to say, yeah.
Right?
Right.
All right. So let's start carrying my tapes. Are we ready?
We're ready.
Let's go.
Blessed. sweet rose of Sharon, you're a love, you're a power, you're merciful and you're mighty, you're the redeemer of all mankind, you're the lion of Judah, you're the ruler of this whole universe, you're the most high Messiah, you're the soul.
fear and doubt come against your mind? Has your faith been so?
I saying is, no one worthy to go. For no one in heaven, no one in earth was worthy to open the scroll. Then one of the elders said, John, don't you weep.
Worthy of honor. give a joyous shout in the honor of the rock of our salvation. Come before him with thankful hearts. Let us sing him songs of praise. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Let us sing him songs of
Up till now, we've been looking through a glass so dark and dim, and only a few mysteries have we known. But I sense now
Cause I'll rise. Jesus.
God bless. You're now saved. born again, one with the Lord, all the same. See you next time.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.